Once it was the stuff of science fiction, a species brought back from extinction after vanishing eons ago. Jonathan Vigliotti surveys the next frontier, de-extinction.
We share this planet with millions of spectacular species, and no matter how different our genetics are, inside this conservation center in Carr, Colorado,
let's go.
There's proof we're all hardwired to fear visiting the doctor. Dr. Della Gorell, a veterinarian with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, is leading the effort to bring one of America's most endangered species back from the brink of extinction.
Who is this?
This is turmeric.
Turmeric.
He's a little spicy today.
Spicy. Yes.
Spicy because the black-footed ferret isn't one for poking and prodding, unless he's given some mild anesthesia.
One liquid ferret.
We were invited to help with physical exams ahead of breeding season.
We also got to check out the goods because, well, they feel pretty good. The only way,
this is very important.
It's a breeding program, right? So can't be shy.
It was only a few decades ago reproduction wasn't thought possible. The species was believed to be extinct due to habitat loss and disease. But in 1981, the federal government tracked down the only known colony and started this breeding program with just 7 ferrets. That makes turmeric
one of the descendants of the few founders, the 7 founders, very related to all the other ferrets.
And very related can be a tricky thing in the genetic pool of life.
Yeah, absolutely. More diversity is better, then you're more prepared for things like change, climate, and otherwise.
Since 1991, more than 4,000 genetically similar ferrets have been released back into the wild, where they help restore balance to the ecosystem. But with such a small gene pool, disease could wipe them all out. That's where wildlife biologist Robin Bortner comes in.
Oh, so you're a matchmaker here.
Yes, I tried to be the ferret matchmaker.
And there's no bigger catch in this dating pool than Elizabeth Ann.
Elizabeth Ann is a black-footed ferret that was produced using interspecies somatic cell nuclear transfer cloning.
In 2020, she was the first endangered species native to North America to ever be cloned, using decades-old DNA from a black-footed ferret named Willa.
Wow, so we're essentially looking at a carbon copy of a black-footed ferret from the 80s.
Yes, correct.
Incredible.
So in here are the cells of Willa that have been frozen since 1988.
So this is where it all began for Elizabeth Ann.
Yes.
Marlis Houck is the curator of the San Diego Frozen Zoo, the largest bank of living animal cells in the world. By collecting and storing all this DNA, the Frozen Zoo is at the forefront of an emerging field, de-extinction. There are more than 10,000 samples, everything from skin to feathers.
When I was freezing cells from the northern white rhino, there were 50 in the living. And then now, you know, there's 2 left.
What does this container of vials represent to you?
The future. The future of these species.
Barbara Durant, the director of reproductive sciences at the Frozen Zoo, says their bank of cells could help save an estimated 1 million species at risk of extinction, mostly because of us.
Have we reached the point where something that was human-caused now can only be cured or corrected by humans?
Yes.
Really?
If we disappeared, a lot of things would grow back, but some populations are so small or don't even exist except here that they would not be able to regenerate without us.
And that next frontier in regeneration may come through cloning. When tissue cells are grown in the lab and then transferred into a donor egg that's had its nucleus and DNA removed, that egg then develops into an embryo, which is implanted into a surrogate. The result? A cloned ferret pup, like Elizabeth Ann. And most recently, Kurt, an endangered Tobolsky horse, whom we watch practice courtship at the San Diego Zoo Safari Park. This de-extinction science got some wondering, what about DNA from species lost ages ago?
We go in, and then we can aspirate a little bit where the DNA might be.
At Colossal Biosciences in Dallas, Texas, this new tech company has raised hundreds of millions of dollars to bring back extinct species like the dodo bird, which died off in the 1600s, and the woolly mammoth, which was wiped out 3,000 years ago.
I hear mammoth and dodo in the same sentence.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's science fiction.
Yeah, I mean, it is until it's not.
Ben Lamb founded Colossal Sciences. He says the first cloned woolly mammoth could be born in 5 years and eventually reintroduced to its native tundra habitat. A dodo chick could take longer because we don't yet know how to clone birds, but...
If you're willing to accept something that is similar to a dodo in some physical way, but not identical, we'll get there a lot sooner than if you want something that is exactly like a dodo.
As paleogeneticist Beth Shapiro explains, an animal's DNA starts to break down in the wild as soon as it dies. So there's no perfectly preserved dodo or woolly mammoth genetic material left. And sorry, this is where we tell you that dinosaur fossils are too old to contain any usable DNA.
This is part of a vertebra, so you can see how big this is.
But Shapiro can still extract pieces of DNA from bones she finds in the field.
We will look at places where the permafrost, the frozen dirt, where many of these bones are preserved, is melting.
The bits of DNA are then extracted from those bones, sequenced in a lab, and used as a template for editing DNA in the cells of the mammoth's closest existing relative, the Asian elephant, to create a creature approaching the real thing.
Why is de-extinction so exciting that it opens up the bank?
People are attracted to the impossible or to what they see as impossible. Would I like to have seen $225 million invested into traditional conservation? Yes. Would I also like to see this money being invested into Colossal so these new tools can be developed? Absolutely yes. And that's where I see the real value of this technology. We can use these same tools to stop species from becoming like the mammoth.
But the science may take longer than expected. It was recently discovered Elizabeth Ann is unable to reproduce.
During the procedure, we discovered that unfortunately her reproductive tract had not developed completely normally.
But the work continues because the easiest way to save a species is to protect it before it's gone.
A room like this, does this help with that battle?
This is in many cases the only thing that's going to help. Once the cells are here, they can be here indefinitely. So it's important that we get the cells now, and then we can work out the techniques for the future.